boy from that soil falls in love and he sees this girl, how differently will he see that girl in the imagination? And that's how the dream song's concept started building.
Ali kept saying, you know, this romantic song will be an item song which is romantic. So don't make it like it needs to not be like a harsh item song at all. If you hear the melody just without the words and without the outfits and all, you'll find that it's a very romantic tune, you know. And then the masti of it has actually come from Irshad bhai.
Main soch raha tha ki koi similes jo ho, jo baatcheet ho, jo metaphors ho, wo Sultan jo kaam kar raha hai, us area ke metaphors ho. So that's why I come up with ke dil mera jaise koi dish antenna tha.
We treated it like a flash forward, like this man's warped imagination, because he comes from a small town in Haryana. Through that song, we also had to see time progress and his attraction towards her, his wanting to woo her, and cutting back and forth with his heightened exaggeration of that emotion.
This was the format that we used to do earlier, cut to Gana.
In reality, like, very mundane activities are happening. Arfa and Sultan are hanging out and they're eating out and, you know, just like general chilling. But Sultan is fantasizing a bit more than what is happening. So there's constantly going back to fantasy and coming back to reality.
हम लोग सेट पे पहुंच जाते हैं, क्या स्टेप क्या है, अच्छा ओके चलो दिखा एक बार. I should actually rehearse it, you know, on my time. But if I'm not shooting for this, I'm shooting for something else, I'm doing some other work. So that time poor nowadays. Dancing does get difficult, but once you are in that groove, I think from the second day you start actually getting into the song.
I have created some out of the world props. Like there was 30 feet high scarecrows in the fields of Punjab. Then there were lot of Mad Max looking vehicles we made for the fair setups. And also we made a wedding setup in a brick quarry in Punjab. So shooting that song was a real fun.
I think we all waited for the entire film and we were missing that. We went all out in Charles & Charles, as you can clearly see. We put a leather jacket, we've made it really rock chic. We have colored the dadis of all the taos into an Argentina color. So I think we've fused it up with the dhotis, the safas, the sunglasses, and I think that's my most favorite section of Charles & Charles as well.
Eat ki bhatti basically looks very fascinating from the outside, but when you stand on that eat ki bhatti, you'd be only dancing. You'd not have any choice but to stand still because it's so hot.
We went for a reiki in the winter. It was very beautiful. Everything was green. There was water around the brick quarries. So everything was very nice and beautiful. And finally, when we went there, it was on that day, I'm not joking, it was 47 degrees Celsius. And the brick quarry was working, so you can add another 25 degrees centigrade over there.
I thought it was a great creative input that I should ask for a glass, which is supposed to be wine in my hand. First, I'm lying on a table looking like an idiot, okay? Then I'm taking a wine glass in my hand, which I'm not able to move now. I'm like restricted. I was more interested in calling the wine wala than doing the actual shot.
On the last day, we had a huge issue in Punjab, and unfortunately, it was the last shooting day of the film.
What we saw there, it's a crowd of 10,000 people has completely surrounded the Mela.
If that would have been cancelled, the whole Mela ka wahan gaon ke andar, the gaon wale thought ke Mela chal raha hai yahan par, and then they got to know ke Salman Khan ki shooting. So there's no chance you can work there, and that too in the night.
When Salman came on set, it was a kind of chaos which happened between them, just to have a jhalak of Salman ki haan mujhe dekhna hai, mujhe dekhna hai. And all were going completely crazy. And we could not shoot. half portion of the shoot.
This is a India schedule rap for Team Sultan.
Look at 440 volt.